How can you tell if your late period was actually a very early miscarriage? This is a question I'm asked all the time, and it's the question that I'm going to answer in today's Fertility Q and A. Hi, I'm Juliette Millar. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years experience. And welcome to today's Fertility Q&A, where I answer your quick questions on all things natural fertility. And if you want to see more videos like this one to get your fertility questions answered, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Today's question comes from Katie, who says, my cycle is extremely regular. This month it was 6 days late, which never happens. Could I have had an early miscarriage, and how can I tell? Well, thanks, Katie, and the answer is yes. A later than normal period can mean an early pregnancy loss, but a late period can also simply be the result of a late ovulation. Ovulating later than usual can be due to things like physical or emotional stress, illness, travel, especially if you change time zones, and normal natural menstrual cycle variation. So how can you tell whether your late period was just due to a late ovulation or whether it was due to an early pregnancy loss? Well, unfortunately, the only way to tell is to know for sure the day that you ovulated on, or to have gotten a positive pregnancy test before your period arrived. So let's look at the first way to tell, by knowing for sure the day that you ovulated on. Knowing the day that you ovulated is really helpful because one way that you can tell you're pregnant with high reliability is if you haven't gotten your period within 18 days after ovulation. So if you get to 18 days or more after ovulation without getting your period, you are most likely pregnant. And then if you start to bleed sometime after this, unfortunately, this is likely to be an early pregnancy loss. Now, finding out this way isn't 100% accurate because occasionally getting your period more than 18 days after ovulation can be the result of having a certain type of ovarian cyst, but this situation isn't that common. So most of the time, getting your period more than 18 days after ovulation will mean a very early miscarriage. Now, of course, the method you use to figure out your day of ovulation makes all the difference. And if you've followed me for a while, you'll know that my number one recommendation for accurately pinpointing your day of ovulation is to chart your fertility. Most fertility apps and even ovulation predictor kits just don't cut it. And you can learn how to correctly chart your fertility step by step in my Fast Track to Pregnancy program, which I'll link to below. The other way to know if you've had an early miscarriage is if you get your period after first getting a positive pregnancy test. So if you've done a pregnancy test, either a blood or a urine test, and got a positive result, even just a faint positive on a urine test, and then you get bleeding that's like a normal period or heavier, then sadly, this usually tells you that you've had an early loss. And if it's very early days, you might even get a warning that this is going to happen by getting a negative pregnancy test after initially getting a positive one. So this is also known as a chemical pregnancy or a biochemical pregnancy because it refers to the fact that the pregnancy was recognized by a pregnancy test only and not by ultrasound. And I've done another video where I talk more about chemical pregnancies, which I'll link to up here. So those are the two ways you can recognize if you've had an early pregnancy loss. But if you don't know for sure the day that you ovulated on and you haven't had a positive pregnancy test, then unfortunately, it's impossible to know the reason for your late period. It could simply be due to a late ovulation. Early losses are extremely common though, and most women will experience an early loss at some stage, often without ever knowing they've had one. And the good news is that having a single early miscarriage does not impact your chances of having a healthy ongoing pregnancy next time. So that's it for today. I hope you found that helpful, and if you've got a quick question that you'd like answered on getting pregnant naturally, just pop it in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer it in another Q&A video if I can. Bye for now.